is going to talk about only variable in the business is you. Please welcome him on the stage.
Success, and launch Kaigoro. So after having a soul search on their strategies, the Edward gave them a breakthrough what they were looking for. So from 98 to 2003, it was a struggling company, and this strategic change in the business model of Edward gave them a revenue of $21 billion in 2008, and in current 2018, 70% of their revenue of $136 billion came only from Edward. So this strategic change of the company which took them on the top. Another case study I would like to give you is about Facebook. Facebook, when it started, it was meant for the college students. And that time, you know, it was not very successful. Later, they tried to introduce in the school, but still, you know, it couldn't get the success what it wanted. In 2006, they came up with a model. They completely overhaul their business model, and they came up with a strategy that any person above age of 13 with a valid email ID can access this. And this strategic change brought a great success to Facebook. In 2009, it was the most popular social network tool. And currently, you know, the third quarter of 2019 revenue was $17.65 billion. In fact, in 2007, Microsoft acquired only 1.6% stake of Facebook at $240 million. So with one strategic shift, the company was taken to a different level. What we learned from all this is the difference between yesterday and tomorrow is the decision you take today. So you know that will determine your tomorrow. Now I'll throw light on some of the inspirational leaders who turn around their companies. Previously we talked about the strategic decisions taken by the board and by the chairman, but now you know certain names are synonym to the company. They are attached to the company. And one of the most powerful is Steve Jobs. Steve Jobs, when he returned in 1996 as an interim CEO, and then later, you know, he was in 1997, he was a permanent CEO of Apple. Apple was struggling, you know, to get a breakthrough. Steve Jobs, what he did as leader, he realized that, you know, Apple has too many projects on hand. They were handling around 350 projects that time. So he cut short that to 50 projects. Then he realized that still we are not focused. So then on, you know, he reduced to 10. So this 10 projects, one of them is the iMac, iPad, iTunes, and the most successful is iPhone. So the focus of the company was, you know, reduced to the key points or the key deliverables, rather than, you know, having a large spectrum of projects and you cannot pay attention to it. During the era of the success of Steve Jobs, their stock went up to 9,000%. So, you know, this many a time we feel that, you know, we have a lot of things in hand. So you have to stop sometime, have a look and reduce to certain numbers where you can pay attention and be focused on that. Another person, you know, I will say is Lakoka of the Chrysler. See, Chrysler is one of the oldest automobile company in the US, and in 1979, they were on the verge of bankruptcy, and they brought in Lee as a CEO, and Lee realized that, you know, this company requires a lot of turnaround. He first, you know, negotiated with the Congress, and he was successful in getting a loan of $1.5 billion in 1979. So you can imagine that value in the current era. And that, with that amount, you know, he introduced two models, K-car and the minivan. He then, you know, negotiated with the workers, negotiated with got some concessions on the suppliers, and had a stronger deal with the union. And then, you know, he turned around the company into a profitable company, and in 1982, in just 3 years, he was able to pay all the loans what he had taken from the Chrysler. So, you know, there are certain person, inducting one, a person, you know, can turn around the company. Another one is an also a classic example of Weizsäcker. In the General Motors, again, you know, automobile sector, you know, it was having a huge deficit, and it was on the verge of bankruptcy. And they bought in Weizsäcker in 2007, he had already retired from AT&T. Weizsäcker was earlier CEO of AT&T, and he had retired. And General Motors saw the strength of Weizsäcker and inducted him as a CEO. And first thing what he came and did was, you know, he sold a loss-making company, SAB, which was a part of the General Motor. And then, you know, he stopped the one project they were working on, Chevrolet Volt, which was in competition with the Toyota Prius, and they stopped that. And in fact, you know, Weizsäcker was known as his name became as a GM Ripper, because he didn't introduce anything. He cut down a lot of things, you know, which General Motor had a burden on them. And then the company started making profits. In just 16 months, the company recovered, and they came out with one of the biggest IPO in the history of $23.1 billion. So the person, when I say that the only variable in the business is you, the top person in the company makes the difference. Maybe country as well. If you see India about 6 years back, the leadership changed, and definitely India changed. Now, right or wrong, good or bad is a debate. Some may say right, some may say wrong, some may say good, some may say bad. But that's a debate, but India did change. If you look at the neighboring country as Pakistan, even the leadership changed, and the country is experiencing change. Nothing changes in the country. The commissioner is the same. The subjects are same, but the leadership, as compared to that example, you know, even US, you see drastic change in the policy after Donald Trump came. So the one person on the top, you know, makes a difference in the organization or the company he is in. Another classic example is of Harley Davidson. It's a US icon. When you say motorcycle, you know, synonym to Harley Davidson in the US. But the company was having a tough competition against Japanese bikes, you know, entering the US market, even against Honda and Yamaha and Suzuki. When Richard was named CEO in 1989, he turned around the focus of the company into quality, and they realized that, you know, what US is famous for. US is famous for everything oversized. You see, the burgers are also quite big, what you get in McDonald's in US. The cars are big. So they focused on the heavy bikes and the large bikes, rather than, you know, competing with the Japanese bikes. So they focused on world-class heavy motorcycles. And Harley Davidson, in no time, recovered 50% market share in the US, and turnaround was around $1.7 billion. The secret, all these things helped us to see that, you know, the secret of change is to focus all our energy not on fighting the old, but to building the new. One, uh, next to go. And see, these are the CEOs who stepped down in 2017. And there is a lot of learning from them. American Express, CEO Ken Chenault, you know, he was in the American Express for almost 27 years. And from 2000, he was holding his position as a CEO. And a fantastic tenure. But, and also he declared his resignation in 2018. But at the end, you know, he focused more on the small customers and the revenue of the American Express went down and drastically, and he had to leave before his retirement. So in this, many a time, you know, it is always advisable that, you know, you have to leave when you are on the high note rather than, you know, when you have a diminishing performance. Uber is one of the example, like, you know, the CEO had to leave because one lady, she blocked of harassment in the company, and based on that block, investigation took place and 20 top officials has to be investigated. And because of that, the CEO had to resign. So anything happens in the company, the leadership is responsible for that. So, you know, good or bad, right or wrong, you know, it all boils down on the leadership. Starbucks, in 2017, Howard had to step down as a CEO role and becoming the executive chairman position. But this, many of the step downs, all the step downs are not for bad or for negative. You know, he stepped down and became an executive chairman position, and he had a lot of aspiration of Starbucks roasteries and Starbucks reserve retail stores. And in that, you know, he opened one of the largest stores in China, which, you know, it is it was an aspiration to have the largest one in the China. Of course, you know, in what we experience in Uber is, you know, as the shortcuts will cut you short, you know, not paying attention on this leadership. And the final slide comes as a good leader does not create followers, he creates leaders. And one classic example I want to share with you is, I see Dr. Rashid, you know, as a perfect fit on this example, because every year I see number of events His Excellency does, and, you know, gathers all the leaders, gathers all the knowledge pool and the think tank, and, you know, stimulates so many ideas, so many new things, which in fact it's a wonderful take home for everyone, and this creates the positive thing happens, you know, and we can apply and experience in our life. So with that note, I end my presentation thanking Dr. Rashid. You know, Your Excellency, you give us this wonderful, creating this wonderful platform and sharing with us, you know, for all the thought leaders to come and share their leadership thought on this. Thank you. Thank you.